I will show you two easy ways how to stabilize videos under Linux. First, I will have to say a few words about algorithms. Algorithms determine the quality of your output. And we have the two algorithms, DShake and VidStub here. Imagine them as if they were functions or libraries. For example, VidStub is a library that can be used by different Linux programs such as FFmpeg, Kdenlive or Shotcut. First, DShake. DShake is a simple single-pass algorithm that stabilizes two axes only, which means it stabilizes in left, right and up, down direction. But it is not very effective. A much better algorithm is VidStub, but it works in two passes. It also has more parameters and is a bit more complicated. In the first pass, it would analyze the file only, and only in the second pass, it would render a video. And it stabilizes for three axes, which means additionally to the two axes that I have mentioned before, it also compensates for rotation. I will show you a simple example using FFmpeg with the DShake algorithm. This can be easily done just with one command. Now theoretically, there are FFmpeg versions out there that also support VidStub, but unfortunately not all Linux distributions have such an FFmpeg. For example, the actual long-term support version Ubuntu 18.04 does not have FFmpeg with VidStub support. I'm right now using Linux Mint, which is based on this Ubuntu, and so I cannot show you. But if you're really interested in FFmpeg with VidStub, then just search the internet for FFmpeg and VidStub, and I'm sure you will find information. This is why it is useful to know about the algorithm, because then you have the right keywords to search for. Instead, I will show you an example using Kdenlive, the Kdenlive video editor, using the VidStub algorithm. Now, don't worry if you are not a Kdenlive user, because this video here is not meant to convert you to a certain editor. Just use Kdenlive as a tool to get a certain job done, to get a video clip stabilized. And once you have the stabilized clip, you can continue with whatever video editor you like. Of course, Kdenlive users most probably already know that function. And if not, you can watch this video. And I will show you, of course, comparison clips between the unstabilized and stabilized versions. So let's get started. I have a small video clip here that is only showing some plants, which I took with an unstabilized camera. And we'll try to get this video stabilized. So these are the parameters that you need. FFmpeg -i followed by the input file name, then VF video filter DShake, and then in the end the output file name. Make sure you choose a different file name for your output than your input file name, otherwise it will destroy your original clip. I will show you a side-by-side comparison right afterwards. But the DShake clip will still have a problem. It will have some flickering effects around the edges. Now, do not worry too much about these flickers, because I will show you right afterwards then how to fix them. They are not a big problem. So here we have the original clip on the left and the DShaked clip on the right. You can easily fix these edge flicker effects with almost any video editor. Just to make that point, I'm using a simple video editor here, which is OpenShot. Not every video editor has a stabilize function, but every video editor has a zoom or scaling function, which you can use to get rid of these flicker effects. First, look at the edges here, just to see the flicker effects. Here on the left side, on the bottom. These flicker effects come from the algorithm shifting the image frame in order to compensate for the shakiness. But then DShake does not automatically crop away the edges, and so instead it fills the edges just with similar pixels. But of course they are noticeable in the video. And in order to get rid of them, I go to the beginning of the clip. Then here in OpenShot I go to Clip Properties. Look for scaling options. Here we have scale X, scale Y. For this particular clip, it should be enough to zoom in by 3%. That should already get rid of the edges. I will show you a full screen comparison of the clips at the end without the flicker effects of the T-shake clip. So next I will show you how to stabilize a video clip with Kdenlive. I have a newer version of Kdenlive installed here, 1904.2, which I downloaded from the Kdenlive project page, kdenlive.org, just as an up image, because the newer versions seem to crash less often, but you can use the repository version of Ubuntu also. So all we need to do is drag the original clip into the project bin. Then next, we right click, go to clip jobs and stabilize. It brings a dialog window with the parameters, but I will go with the defaults. Now it does some calculation, which is basically the first step of the stabilization process. You remember it's a two-pass algorithm, and in this pass it only computes the shakiness of the clip. Then it creates an additional file. In this version of Kdenlive it creates it under a folder called stabilized. If you have an older version of Kdenlive, it might not create this separate folder, it would just create the file. You will recognize it by the extension of .mlt. So this is only the analyzed clip. In order to make it a real video, you have to drag it to the timeline and render it out. Make sure that it is left aligned on the timeline. And then you go to render to create a video file as an output. Now in this dialog, if you invoke it the first time, you might not have the favorite custom setting here yet. You have to first select a video format, whatever you want as an output. I had clicked on MP4 and then this star icon here, which created this entry here as a favorite. Then we choose the output path. I will put it into the same directory as the original clip. And I will give it a name with the term bitstab inside, so that we know that this is the stabilized version. And then only click the render button and it will do its job. Okay, Kdenlive is finished. Now if you do not want to continue with Kdenlive as an editor, you just can close the whole thing. I do not even save anything. If we look at the files that we have now in our folder, this was the original file, this was the T-shake clip, this is our newly created stabilized clip, and these two files here were created by Kdenlive for the stabilization process, the MLT and MLT.trf. Since I do not continue now with Kdenlive, I can just delete them. Of course, if you use Kdenlive as your main editor, you would keep all the files. They become part of your project. And here's the side-by-side. On the left, the unstabilized clip. On the right side, the vidstab stabilized clip. And vidstab crops automatically. There's no additional work needed. And finally, here is a full screen comparison. First, the original clip with all the shakiness. Here is T-shake, the edge flicker effect is already cropped away. And finally vidstab. And as you can see, vidstab really has good results. So that was it. Thanks for watching.